Congressman Chip Roy out of the great state of Texas. We just played that audio of him telling everybody because people needed to get told. Congressman, thank you so much for joining us. Let me ask you this question. Are we going to pretend that the new CR is any better than the old CR?
It's total garbage.
Okay, let me ask you the second question. Is the reason that everyone's acting like the new CR better than the old CR because Mike Johnson endorsed Trump and McCarthy looked like he wasn't in that circle? I'm just trying to understand the dynamics of why Johnson making a deal with Democrats is better than McCarthy making a deal with Democrats. And I say this as someone who has an OG McCarthy disliker.
So, first of all, joking aside about just calling it garbage, it is garbage.
It is.
Perpetuating Pelosi spending levels and priorities. It is no better.
You got Ukraine funding. Ukraine funding's in it. All the bad stuff. No border.
United Nations funding, including UNRWA with dollars to get the Palestinians, get to Hamas. Continued perpetuation of the funding of the abortion tourism policies, all the transgender surgery policies of the Department of Defense. Continues to fund the Department of Justice at war with the American people, ATF that wants to confiscate your guns, pistol braces. All of those things we're continuing to fund. All in the name of we'll fight later. So to answer your question, it is no better than the CR under Kevin McCarthy. It's just as bad and just as deserving of rebuke. Now, again, I want to be clear. Mike is my friend. I like Mike. I actually think Mike understands where we want to go. I'm giving him some grace, but I'm telling him, man, you've just used up some of your lives. You know, this is kind of, to use the baseball metaphor, strike one and two. When we come back after Thanksgiving, let's go. Let's, you know, we'll get through this now. You've done it. It's already done. So now what? When we get back to Thanksgiving,
correct me if I'm wrong, because didn't they suspend the basic, like the rules that everyone said were really, really precious until they weren't?
It was passed under a suspension of the rules. Now, in fairness, it was because some of us were going to oppose the rule because we didn't like the rule. And so he suspended the rules to pass it. But, you know, that's not the way to do business.
I'm just trying to understand why we went through this whole thing of getting a new speaker so that we could get more conservative stuff. And where's the more conservative stuff I was promised?
Well, to be very clear for everybody out there, what you and I just talked about, it's continuing those spending levels with all of those policies.
Yeah,
I believe we could have had an approach where we could have sent over something that isn't what I want, but something that we could have at least said we were getting something for. And we talked to Mike last week about that.
Right.
Send over a bill at the current spending level, which I hate, but get paid for the disaster funding, $16 billion, and get Israel paid for, send it over to the Senate and dare them to vote against funding for the troops, funding for Israel, and that we are paying for all supplementals. Live to fight another day, separate DHS, have an isolated fight on DHS after the new year. I thought we could sell that. We were working conservatives, even though it funded all manners of sins that I hate.
Right.
Because I wanted to be a team player and unite us. You have 217. That's what I think he should have done. He didn't. So now the Senate's going to pass this, and we're going to perpetuate this funding to January. I don't know how we're going to isolate a fight in January, but I'm sure as hell going to try. At every stage, I'm going to keep fighting. And we're going to do this. We're moving the ball in the right direction. Okay, Dana, let's always be positive. Okay. We're on our side of the football field. This isn't an omni. This isn't increasing spending. It's a CR of last year's levels, which I find absolutely abhorrent. But it's at least on our side of the field. We're holding spending in check with a CR, and we're trying to force it to cuts. We're trying to force pay force for the supplementals. We're trying to force border security. So my job is to keep taking Mike now as the new speaker and say, look, let's get back on our side of the field and let's go frigging do the job.
So I love that you used a football metaphor because I don't know anything about football, but I just nodded yes because everyone else does. We're talking with Congressman, it's a long running joke. Talking with Congressman Chip Roy about this. Okay, so the next fight on this is going to be in January. Then I imagine it'll be another temporary thing, right? Because again, I get the arguments from my moderate friends, and I respect that you say Mike Johnson's your friend, but I also like that you view this as, well, this is show business of the country, not show friends of the country. Where does that put us? So like we have this fight again in January, where does that put us?
Well, I mean, we're going to be in the same position, right? Where they're going to have members of our conference who don't want to have a shutdown, who do all the hand-wringing and say, well, we can't do that. Troops won't get paid. Border Patrol won't get paid. All of those things, all of which are concerning issues, but you just have to address them. Mm. So we're going to be in that same position if we're unwilling to demonstrate we're willing to fight. And at some point you have to say, we're not waiting to get a different level of majority or waiting to get a certain number in the Senate or waiting to get a president. We have a majority. Let's use it.
Now, three again, seats, Dana, though. It is tough. Three seats.
It is thin. It is thin. And it was thin for Kevin. It's thin for Mike. I was giving a lot of grace along the way to Kevin to try to move this forward, figure out the numbers. Same with Mike. I'll give him grace. Right. But you got to get, when it comes down to deal time, you got to get something. Set up the fight and get some.
I get it. We're up against a hard break, though. Congressman Chip Roy, we appreciate you fighting the good fight on behalf of everyone, especially us here in Texas, but on behalf of everybody. And keep us updated. I know we'll be following it as well. But I appreciate your candor and your passion. Thank you. We got to get rolling, though. Wish we had more time. Well, love to have you back. You just say the word. Congressman Chip Roy, God bless.